Any other questions? So if your puppy goes into a crate and starts whining, if you're using it as a management tool to prevent that biting behavior, that frustrated behavior, wait for a moment of quiet and then allow them back out. You don't want to ever let them out while they're crying, because when you do, they're going to be like, if I bark in my crate, my mom will come. And that's one surefire way to start training them to become more anxious when you're gone. So especially if you think you're ever going back to the office again or to school or to ever leave our houses again, which hopefully we will be able to again. But if your puppy starts crying and it predicts that it's going to make you come, you just kind of, they will figure that out and they will start training you. If, however, you can just kind of wait through it and eventually they'll quiet down and settle down. When they're quiet for just a few seconds, then you get up and let them go. Even looking when they're bark, 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 and you look at them, oh good, I made my mom look at me. Bark. Oh good, I made my mom look at me. So they can start to train you pretty easily. This is usually the case that I would make for noise-canceling headphones if you happen to have them in your house. Or if you have, I know we have some students here who have single-family homes, and we have students here who have apartments. If you're in a single-family home, you have a great advantage where you can put that crate in a place where they can just bark and eventually they will settle down. That is called an extinction burst. And an extinction burst is effectively, if I put money into a soda machine and I push the button and the soda doesn't come out, what do? And then you eventually give up. You might even push the button a bunch of times and then you get up and you walk away, right? This behavior didn't work. It didn't get me what I expected, so I'm going to leave. But if sometimes it pays off, I go, and then the soda comes out, oh, that worked. So the next time it happens, I might do that a little bit longer. The same with our puppies as they start to bark in their crate. If you, and keep in mind, not every puppy is going to be okay in a crate. There's a difference between I'm demanding you come back to me and I'm sad, and full-blown separation anxiety. Those two things are on very different ends of a spectrum, and we would treat those slightly a lot differently. But for most puppies who have been in a crate, who can sleep in a crate, who are okay if you leave the room, those puppies can kind of have a little temper tantrum and be okay. It's the puppies who have full-blown anxiety where they start digging at the crate, they break their teeth, they're really suffering. Those are the puppies that we don't want that to happen with your puppy. If you're seeing that with your puppy, call me or send me an email offline and I will happily talk you through a different protocol. But generally speaking, we would ignore that behavior if you have a single family home. If you have an apartment, especially if you have a landlord on the premises, that might not work very well for you. If you have a landlord on the premises, or you're worried that your neighbors are going to call and you're going to get in trouble with your barking puppy, because now that is sound pollution and that can affect somebody else's like life and their existence in their home and feeling peace in their home. So if that's the case, then we would try to get ahead of it. We would actually train. You go in your crate for 2 seconds and I walk away from you. And then I put you in your crate and then I walk away for 3 seconds and then I come back to you, and I always come back. So it would actually be a longer training process, and that's a lot more on the owner, but you can also get the same quiet behavior in the crate. It just takes a little bit longer if you're actively training it in that way, compared to just letting them extinguish, have that extinction burst, that temper tantrum, oh, that didn't work. And it only, I only get to see my mom if I'm quiet in my crate, so I'm gonna be quiet. And then you come back and you let them out. That's a very good question. So in general, if you're using the crate for house training, so I guess we'll just jump into house training because I think it dovetails nicely into that conversation. So if you are using a crate for house training, or even if you're not, the general idea is when your puppy cries, you want to try to get them outside. You don't want to ignore that alarm bell in the event that it is an emergency, right? Like those of us who have had kids understand if they say they have to pee, they have to pee. But your puppy doesn't speak English and they can't communicate to you and say, I have to pee versus I'm lonely. Those two sound very similar sometimes. So one thing you can do is if you're hearing whining in the middle of the night, maybe give it a minute. And if they don't settle down, you just go down and very non-emotionally pick up your puppy, take them out, leash them, take them outside, give them 2 minutes to pee. So they're not going outside to play. It's you go out, you pee. If they pee in those 2 minutes, fantastic. Then they can maybe play tug for a minute or two and then go back in their crate, or you give them something to chew on in their crate and you go back to bed. If, however, they're just like, hey, 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 I'm out, jailbreak. In that case, what we would do is we would just put them back in the crate and we would let that extinguish. Like, that whining means we are literally just going outside. And if you don't pee, sorry, kid, it's still dark 30, you're going back to bed. And that process takes a little bit of time to work through. Now, moving through house training in general, one of the biggest issues that I tend to see is the puppy. I think one of you guys had mentioned this earlier. Your puppy goes outside for a while and then doesn't pee or poop. And then as soon as you bring it in the house, on the kitchen floor. And that's a bad day for everyone. So to prevent that, I'm always on board for prevention instead of preventing a situation instead of reacting to a worse one. In general, what I would recommend is along the lines of what I was just describing. You take the puppy out for 2 minutes. If they pee, great. That pee indicates, if it's not 4:30 in the morning, that pee indicates let's go for a walk. Let's play. Let's do whatever. You get an hour of freedom, kid. And then they play. And then after that hour, set your cell phone. Set the timer on your smartphone. Or if you have like a kitchen timer on your stove, set a timer for 1 hour. And if your puppy at that hour, as soon as you hear that beep, 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 even if you're on a very important phone call, hold on, I'll be right back. Take your puppy outside and stand there and give them 2 minutes. If they don't pee in those 2 minutes, they go back in their crate for 20. And then after 20, they go back out. So they don't get freedom back until they pee outside. But I don't want them to go outside and realize, oh, I'm outside. I'm going to go chase bunnies and butterflies and all this other stuff. Because what generally happens, at least what I found out here in the city, is if you're an owner and you take your puppy outside to pee and they pee, you're like, yay, you peed. Let's go in the house. I got to go to work. So the puppy figures out my peeing makes me go back inside into that crate. So they are learning to hold it. They're just learning to hold it in the wrong environment. You want them to pee outside. So you want them to pee, and that's the cue for them to get to go for a walk or get to go play or get to play tug or get to do a game. Peeing means good things instead of peeing means mom's going to work, I'm going to get locked in my crate. So keep that in the back of your head too. As your puppy gets older, the general rule of thumb is your puppy should be able to hold it for their number of months in hours. So if your puppy is 2 months old, they should be able to hold it for 2 hours during the day. Give or take, like that's just a guidepost. If your puppy is maybe never been in a home, that might be a lot lower. That might be 30 minutes, but it's at least a target goal for you to work backwards from. And then like when they're 4 months old, they should be able to hold it for 4 hours. The bladder is a muscle and it has to get stronger. And the way it gets stronger is by holding it and holding it, but not to the point of pain or exploding all over the crate or your house. It gets stronger by just pushing it a little further and a little further and a little further and showing them exactly where you want them to go. Now, rubbing their nose in it doesn't help. and the reason I mentioned that is because I just had a student that was emailing me going, she keeps running under the dining room table. She had like a little chihuahua. She keeps running under the dining room table and peeing. And I'm watching her do it. And then she looks at me like, that felt great. And then she runs off. So I want you guys to think about being on the highway after drinking a lot of coffee and then seeing a sign that says next rest stop 50 miles. And those last 10, you're like, I'm not gonna make it. And as soon as you park your car, you do the pee shuffle into the Burger King, you pee and you feel great. You might even go, nothing is more reinforcing than peeing when you really have to go. So then going and backtracking and rubbing your puppy's nose in it, they've already been reinforced for peeing, and then they've already forgotten about it. So rubbing their nose in it isn't going to help. And if anything, it's going to make it worse when you try to take them out on a leash, because now they see you and you keep rubbing their face and pee. So I don't want to pee and have my face rubbed in it. My human is crazy. So we're not going to do that. So if you happen to catch it, there's this chemical called Nature's Miracle. It's an enzymatic cleaner. you pour it on where they've peed, but you have to wait like 5 to 10 minutes before you clean it up. Don't just pour it and wipe it back up. You have to wait a little bit of time, and it'll enzymatically break down all of the, I pee here smells that your puppy will pick up. So hopefully that helps you guys a little bit with some house training too. And again, you can use the crate, you can use a tether, you can use a waist leash. I actually have a lot of students in the city because they might not have room for a crate in their apartment, so they actually use a waist tether. So as the puppy starts to spin, they just pick the puppy up and go outside. And then as soon as the puppy pees, then they go for a walk, or then they go dig something up, somebody's rhododendron or something. So there's that on house training. So generally speaking, if your puppy's in the crate, the question was, if my puppy, if I'm using the crate as a training tool, can she stay in there for the full 3 to 4 hours? And it depends on the age and the ability of that particular puppy. So a lot of dog training is me telling you, it depends. It depends on the dog you have. So like if your puppy is able to hold it for 2 or 3 hours during the day, great. Now, this is one important thing that I kind of forgot to mention. They will be able to sleep through the night before they can go 3 or 4 hours during the day holding it. And the reason is metabolism. When they're up, they're moving, they're running, they're drinking, they're eating, they're processing, their body is on, and they're constantly processing all of their energy, and they're gonna have to pee more and poop more, and they're growing and all of these other things. So they're going to be eliminating more frequently during their waking hours. Then their body is almost like a CPU unit and just hibernates, goes to sleep for a little while. And so while they're not processing as much or as quickly, they will be able to hold it for much longer during the night. So if you have a puppy who's sleeping through the night, don't be frustrated if they're not able to hold it for 2 or 3 hours during the day when they're active. Those are two different skills that they're going to have, so don't panic. And to be perfectly honest, right now this is a kind of hard time to house train for puppies, because it's light for so many hours during the day. Simon was saying getting up at 4:30 in the morning. Solidarity, I feel so bad for you. But it will get better, I promise, as it starts to get dark longer. So you'll be able to like kind of trick your puppy into holding it a little bit longer because the sun won't be up as early. So you will be able to start sleeping a little bit more and a little bit more as the sun starts to come up a little bit later and a little bit later. So you will, there is relief on the horizon, just not until September.